So, you have a movie for me?
Yes, sir, I do. You're gonna love this one. Hans Zimmer is already on board.
That's a good sign. He's great.
Yeah, I mean, he only just started working on it, but he has some great stuff already.
Oh, I bet. What'd he come up with?
Bwah! I like the sound of that. We should put it in every action movie trailer for the next decade.
That sounds great to me, sir.
So what's this movie about? What's got Zimmer all riled up?
Well, sir, this whole movie's gonna be about dreams.
Oh, very exciting.
Last night I dreamt I was a balloon.
Oh, I mean... okay.
Yeah, it was a ton of fun,
and then suddenly frightening. Anyway, maybe that could be in the dream movie.
Oh, absolutely not that kind of dream movie, sir.
Okay, I mean, that is a riveting dream idea, though. So what kind of dreams are gonna be in this movie?
Well, the movie's gonna be about this guy, Dom Cobb, and his team, right?
Okay, and what's their deal?
Well, they, like, build these shared dream worlds that they extract information from.
How does that work?
Well, I'm glad you asked.
Oh, you're taking a deep breath.
So the team brings a dreamer into a dream world built by an architect, and then the dreamer fills that world up with projections of their subconscious, which are essentially just people walking around. But if you change things too much, projections will get angry and attack you. And also, you can't build places based on real places, because then it's hard to know what the real world is and what's the dream world. And so they get information by placing safes in the dream, which dreamers automatically fill with their secrets. Or sometimes you can get information by just talking to projections. Oh, and also you need a totem to keep your grasp on what's a dream and what's not. Essentially, it's like a little thing that only you're allowed to touch.
Sorry, don't want to cut you off, but little things that only you're allowed to touch are tight. Okay, keep going.
Okay, yeah, sure. And also, to wake up from a dream, a timer has to run out. Or you need to die in the dream, or you can also wake up with a kick, which is a jolting sensation of falling, or sometimes of hitting the water. We're gonna be slightly inconsistent on that.
Wow, okay, so that is a whole lot of information.
It sure is, sir. That's why 80% of the movie is gonna be characters explaining the movie to each other.
That'll probably help. So what are we calling this movie? Extraction?
No, actually, it's gonna be called Inception.
I thought they extracted information from dreams.
Normally they do, but on the job in this movie, they're gonna be implanting an idea into somebody's mind.
Maybe we should just call it Dream Squad, you know, cover all our bases.
Oh, definitely not.
Dream Buddies, Dream Team.
Oh, I would just love to stick with Inception, sir.
Well, okay then. So what's this idea they need to implant?
Well, this super rich business guy, Sato, he wants to get his competitor, Fisher, to dissolve his father's empire.
Okay.
And he promises to get all of Cobb's charges dropped, so of course Cobb says yes.
Wait, what are Cobb's charges?
Well, his wife, Moll, was convinced that they were still in a dream, so she frames him for her death, so he has no choice but to kill himself, too.
Oh, how does she do that?
She has herself declared sane by three psychiatrists, and she files a report saying that Cobb threatened to kill her, and then she jumps out a frickin' window.
Oh, no.
Of the building across the street from where Cobb is standing.
Well, I mean, it'd be pretty simple to prove he didn't do it then, right? Just check the security footage of the building he's in at the time of death?
Yeah, well, maybe it's all a dream. Who knows?
Oh, my God, what?
Anyway, so Cobb is on the run in Europe, and all he wants is to see his kids again.
Well, too bad he doesn't know anyone that could fly them to Europe.
Well, his dad could, I guess. He flies back and forth a lot, but he's not gonna.
Why not? So the movie can happen.
Okay, gotcha. So how does Inception work anyway?
Uh-oh.
So to perform Inception, they need to have multi-level dreams, like dreams within dreams. And it's best if the idea they're trying to plant comes from a father figure, and there's some time dilation between the levels of the dreams. So time stretches out further the deeper you go, and to wake up, you need a chain of synchronized kicks on all the levels at once, which you can synchronize by playing music in the ears of the dreamers.
Okay, cool, got it.
Really?
I don't know.
Anyway, so this guy Sato says that if Cobb is successful, he makes a single phone call and the charges are dropped.
A very powerful business guy.
So Cobb needs an architect, so he gets his dad to recommend one of his students.
Who does he end up with?
This girl Ariadne, and let me tell you, he puts her skills to the test before hiring her.
How does he do that?
He asks her to draw a maze in 2 minutes that takes 1 minute to solve.
Well, what does that have to do with any-
And she does.
Oh, she does? Okay, yeah, that's impressive. Okay, get her on the dream team.
Yeah, and so because she's new, now the characters have someone to explain things to nonstop.
That's smart.
So they're gonna teach her all about building dream worlds. She's gonna do crazy stuff like fold a city in half.
Well, so I imagine we're gonna have a bunch of mind-bending action stuff when they start the job, huh?
Actually, not a ton of it. No, every dream's gonna look like a generic James Bond level.
Oh.
Well, they don't want Fisher to realize he's dreaming, you know? There is gonna be an amazing gravity-related hallway thing, though.
Oh, there is? That sounds fun.
Yeah, because in one dream level, a van flips over, and you know, that messes up the whole gravity of the level below it.
Wouldn't a van flipping count as a kick?
Apparently not.
And wouldn't the gravity shift for all the levels below it too?
Apparently not.
Well, okay then.
Anyway, so when they get in the dream, it turns out that Fisher has his subconscious trained for this kind of thing.
Oh, what does that mean?
Well, it means his projections are in full-on defense mode. I mean, they have guns, and occasionally they hit their targets.
But I mean, if the characters die, they just wake up, right?
No, not anymore.
What? Why not?
Well, I need the audience to care about the action now, so they're all sedated, and if if they die, they go to this place called Limbo that messes your mind up.
Oh, that doesn't sound good. So what do?
Well, they try real hard to stay alive. This guy Arthur is shooting at projections and stuff.
Okay.
And this guy Eames pops in with a grenade launcher like, you mustn't be afraid to dream a little bigger, darling.
So if they can conjure stuff up in the dream, why not conjure up some bulletproof vests or an armored car?
Well, I told you, if they draw too much attention to themselves, the projections attack them.
But the projections are already attacking them.
Oh, whoops.
Whoopsie.
So anyway, they're gonna keep going on with the mission, and Maul is gonna keep popping up and ruining stuff. Like, she makes a train show up, she kills Fisher and sends him to Limbo.
Oh, very rude.
And so eventually, Sato and Fisher are both down in Limbo, and Ariadne and Cobb, they go down to get them.
Wow, so if dying sends you to Limbo, it must be impossible to get out of Limbo.
Actually, it's gonna be super easy. Barely an inconvenience.
Oh, really?
Yeah, because when you're down there, you either ride the kick up or you die. Both of those will wake you up.
Oh, okay, so it's just another level then.
With a lot of time distortion and a fun little name.
Limbo is a pretty fun name.
So Ariadne and Fisher, they ride the kick up, but Cobb goes to try to find Sato.
Okay.
But since Sato's been down there a while, he's all old now.
Oh, interesting.
So we're gonna have to make the actor look much older than he actually is. Is that something we can do?
Oh, we have some great prosthetics. We can make him look like a very old Muppet.
Did you say Muppet?
I might have. Who's to say?
So then the plane that they're doing this whole thing on lands in America, and Cobb gets into the country, no problem, thanks to Sato's help.
Won't it take several months to know if the Inception actually worked or not?
Yep, but the movie's almost over, so let's pretend like that's not the case.
Well, I do like pretending.
And then Cobb gets home and he spins his top totem, because if it falls, that means he's not dreaming. But then he sees his kid, so he doesn't even check it.
Oh, so does it fall? Is he still dreaming?
It's gonna slightly wobble, and then we're gonna cut to black.
So maybe he's still dreaming?
Maybe he's still dreaming.
Wow, 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 wow.
Or maybe the whole movie was a dream.
Oh, yeah, oh, yeah, right.
Or maybe he never actually returned to the US, and Sato just put him in a dream with his kids.
Oh, right.
Or maybe it doesn't actually mean anything, because his real totem is his wedding ring.
Oh, please stop.
This is never gonna stop.
Well, at least people will be talking about the movie a lot, and hey, if they are, maybe we can make an even more complicated movie in the future.
That sounds good to me.
Hey guys, it's Ryan here. Hope you like that pitch meeting. There are over 100 episodes of Pitch Meeting on the channel that you could check out. I also have some other videos on there, so click around. Also, let me know in the comments section what other movies you'd like to see these pitches for. Don't forget to hit the like button, the subscribe button, the bell button, the button, I don't know. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you next time.